Imagine watching a World Cup match, not from the ground, but 350 meters above the desert. No crowds pushing at stadium gates, no parking lots stretching for miles, just a gleaming arena suspended in the air, surrounded by the endless reflection of the Arabian sands. This is the NEOM Sky Stadium, the world's first ever stadium in the sky. A $1 billion project designed to challenge everything we know about sports architecture. Set within the line, Saudi Arabia's futuristic vertical city, this structure isn't just about football. It's a symbol of ambition, innovation, and a nation rewriting its place in the modern world. Saudi Arabia is changing faster than almost any country on Earth. Under its Vision 2030 plan, the kingdom is transforming from an oil-driven economy into a hub for tourism, technology, and sport. The 2034 FIFA World Cup will be the ultimate showcase of that transformation. To prepare, Saudi Arabia is constructing a network of next-generation stadiums, each one designed to astonish. Yet none are as bold or as unlikely as the NEOM Sky Stadium. Built not on land but suspended hundreds of meters above it, this project is unlike anything attempted before. The Sky Stadium will rise 350 meters above the desert floor, about the height of the Empire State Building. It will sit within the line, NEOM's most famous mega project, a 170 kilometer long, 200 meter wide linear city, stretching from the Red Sea deep into the desert. The line is more than just a city. It's an entirely new model of living. Its mirrored walls conceal layers of homes, offices, and transport networks stacked vertically to house up to 9 million people. At its core, the Sky Stadium will serve as the city's central gathering space, a vast arena floating within the mirrored canyon. Instead of driving to matches, fans will reach their seats through high-speed electric pods and vertical elevators built directly into the line's transport system. It's a new way of thinking about stadium design. Compact, vertical, and integrated directly into the fabric of urban life. The NEOM Sky Stadium carries an estimated price tag of $1 billion, making it one of the most expensive sports venues ever built per seat. Construction is scheduled to begin in 2027, with completion planned for 2032, 2 years before the World Cup. The project is being developed jointly by NEOM, Saudi Arabia's Ministry of Sport, and the Public Investment Fund. International firms specializing in extreme engineering and sustainable architecture have been brought on board to make this vision real. The engineering challenge is staggering. The stadium won't sit on traditional foundations, but will instead be supported by massive composite columns integrated into the line's superstructure. Engineers are experimenting with high tensile materials capable of handling enormous loads while minimizing vibration and wind movement. Every component must be light enough to suspend, but strong enough to hold tens of thousands of people safely in the air. From the outside, the NEOM Sky Stadium looks like it belongs in a science fiction film. Its mirrored exterior reflects the surrounding desert, allowing it to blend seamlessly into the line's silver skyline. During the day, the structure almost disappears against the horizon. At night, it comes alive. Thousands of embedded LED panels illuminate the exterior in shifting patterns, giving the illusion that the stadium is floating in midair. The roof is one of its defining features, a sweeping surface made of glass-like panels that fracture light like shards of crystal. It's designed to respond to the environment, adjusting to control sunlight, temperature, and airflow. Inside, the seating bowl has been modeled on a beehive pattern to ensure optimal sight lines from every angle. The acoustics have been carefully engineered so that even a single chant can roll through the structure like thunder. With a capacity of around 46,000, it promises a match day experience unlike anything else on Earth. A football game with the desert below and the skyline surrounding you on all sides. Like everything in NEOM, the Sky Stadium will be fully powered by renewable energy. Solar and wind farms across the region will supply the venue through the line's integrated energy grid. Smart systems will constantly adjust cooling, lighting, and power use based on real-time conditions, ensuring no excess energy is wasted. Fans will arrive through an entirely electric transport system, autonomous pods and underground hyper-connected lines, replacing the noise and chaos of car parks. Inside, an advanced digital infrastructure will create a personalized fan experience, blending augmented reality and live analytics directly into the viewing environment. Every aspect of the venue is designed for zero emissions, from waste management to water recycling. The surrounding sports district will include training centers, accommodation, and entertainment areas, all designed under strict net zero carbon standards. When Saudi Arabia hosts the 2034 FIFA World Cup, the Sky Stadium will stand as one of its most remarkable venues. It's expected to host matches from the group stages through to the quarterfinals, serving as a dramatic symbol of the tournament's futuristic character. Other host venues will include the 92,000-seat King Salman International Stadium in Riyadh, the cliffside Prince Mohammed bin Salman Stadium in Qiddiya, the desert-inspired New Maraba Stadium, and the vortex-shaped Aramco Stadium in Al Khobar. Together, they represent over $20 billion in investment, the largest stadium development program in World Cup history. But while the others push boundaries in form and capacity, the Sky Stadium pushes boundaries in imagination. It's not about being the biggest or loudest, but about changing how we define a stadium altogether. When the World Cup ends, the Sky Stadium's story won't stop there. It's designed as a permanent feature of NEOM, serving as a year-round destination for sports, concerts, and cultural events. It could even become the home of a permanent football club, playing matches against some of the world's top teams. For NEOM, this isn't just a stadium. It's an anchor for a new kind of urban life, where sports, technology, and community all exist within a single, self-contained environment. Visitors might stay in nearby vertical hotels, ride a lift straight to their seats, dine in the sky, and return to apartments only a few levels above the pitch. The concept merges city living with event culture in a way that's never been attempted before. It's not a district built around a stadium. It's a stadium built into a city. The world's reaction has been divided. Supporters see the Sky Stadium as a glimpse into the future, a daring experiment in how humanity might build in vertical, compact, and sustainable ways. Architects and urban planners have praised its ambition, calling it a symbol of what's possible when traditional limitations are ignored. Skeptics, however, question whether it can actually be done. Building a 46,000-seat arena hundreds of meters in the air raises complex challenges: structural vibration, crowd safety, emergency evacuation, and long-term maintenance. Environmentalists argue that while the stadium's operations may be net zero, the resources needed to build it could still have a heavy carbon footprint. Despite these concerns, construction on NEOM continues, and the Sky Stadium remains one of its most closely watched projects. Whether it succeeds or not, it captures something bigger than engineering. It captures intent, a statement that Saudi Arabia is not only building for today, but reaching for the future. The NEOM Sky Stadium represents the boldness that defines this new era of Saudi development. A $1 billion arena suspended in the air, powered entirely by clean energy, and built to host the world's biggest sporting event. If completed, it won't just be another stadium. It will redefine how we think about architecture, urban design, and human experience. It might seem like a dream too high to reach, but so did the line itself. And yet construction is already underway. The Sky Stadium is more than an engineering project. It's a question made of steel and glass, asking us to imagine a different kind of world. Is this the future of sports? Or just a glimpse of a dream suspended in the sky?